Hello, today I would like to show how the OpenEO JavaScript client can be used to communicate with OpenEO backends. For this, I'm using the OpenEO web editor, which is using the OpenEO JavaScript client in the background. The OpenEO web editor can be used to easily write process graphs and scripts using the OpenEO JavaScript client. These scripts can then be executed on the backends, and the results can be realized directly in the browser. We can now connect to a server by typing the URL into this text field, or we can select one of the previously used servers, for example the CentralHub server, and after connecting to the server it automatically loads the data that is supported by the server. It also shows which processes are supported by the server, and it adapts the tabs below the script editor to reflect the capabilities of the server. For example, this server supports adding web services, it supports adding process graphs, and it also allows to upload files to the server. For example, polygons that can be used for further calculations or any additional files that are needed for processing. What we can do now is that we load use case one of the proof of concept, and it basically is that we create an image collection based on SentinelOne data, apply a date range filter, calculate the NDVI, and make a max time composite. We can now preview what this script does. And we can request a PNG file that is directly shown in the browser. That doesn't really look nice, so we might want to add a visualization. For example, to stretch the colors. And we need to specify different arguments that are requested now, and we have predefined them here. Now that we have defined the visualization, we can rerun this script on the server. We can request a PNG file again, and after it's visualized, we can see it in the browser. That looks pretty nice. So I'm now happy with the results, and we can add this script to the server as a job. Now we can see the details of the job, and now we can create a service based on that. The service has been created. It's shown here. It's a WMS, and now we can render it on the map. The tiles are generated on the fly, and it also applies the visualization function again. What we also might want to do is to run this use case on another server. That's easily possible. We can just go to the server panel again and for example select the WCPS server by URAC. After changing the server, it automatically loads the data sets available and the processes, and as we can see, the services tab is not available at the moment, so this server doesn't support any web services. But this server, for example, allows us to download the files. But for download, we don't want to download files from the whole world, so we need to add a bounding box filter. I prepared a script for that, which adds the bounding box filter and also adapts to the different dataset names. Other than that, it's basically the same. It's use case one again. And we can now try this script out. You might just want to get a JSON file, for example, from the server. And that's now rendered into the data tab. It's pretty ugly, but we can see that the data values are looking correct. So we can now go ahead and add this process graph to the server as a job. The job is created, and this time it allows us to download the process results as a file. With this server, the results are again processed on demand. So just as we click the download button and send the request, the data is processed. This time we might want to get a TIFF file. The download is requested by the web editor and downloaded to our computer, as we can see here. We can now click on it and it opens in a image viewer, and the file looks pretty good. Great. We can also try this out on the EODC backend, which is powered by OpenShift. This server needs authentication, so we can now type in our user details. And afterwards, it again loads automatically the data sets that are available, the processes, which this time have changed. And yeah, we need again to adapt to the data set names because they're different and need to change that here. Other than that, nothing has changed in the process graph. So we can add that to the server again. We don't specify any file format for now. We can just create it and we're downloading the file. It has been added. This time the server doesn't support lazy processing, so we just need to pre-process the data and can download it only after it has been processed. So we need to queue this job as a batch job before by clicking this button. It has now been queued. The server now starts to process the file for us, and afterwards we can download it. As this takes 1 or 2 minutes, I will not show this today. It's basically the same, clicking on the download button like before, specifying what file format we would like to have. GeoTIFF, for example, again, and we can download it. That's a demonstration of use case one of the proof of concept of the OpenMeO project. It was shown that the JavaScript client can communicate with these three backends I've shown here. Thank you for watching.